All right, well, Oonagh Williams joins us. She's in the Newsman kitchen making a gluten-free pumpkin cake. And it's tricky when you're baking and yes. you want to be gluten-free. What's the issue?
The issue is that regular wheat flour has this thing called gluten in it, which is the elasticity that holds it together. So when you bake bread, it rises and it's spongy and it sets in place. And even with ordinary cakes, it holds them in place once they're baked. Too often with gluten-free stuff collapses because it's not a strong enough flour. Too many of them are just cornstarch, potato starch, tapioca starch, which has very little strength for holding stuff together. And you still have to add this stuff called xanthan gum, or guar gum, which is like an edible glue, which is meant to take the place of the gluten. Thankfully, this pumpkin bread is the regular flour pumpkin bread I've made for forever. I mean, I think I've done the regular one on Cook's Corner before now, so it's on my website, Royal Temptations. So it's basically the identical recipe, just with a few tweaks to it. So in here I've got eggs, I've got genuine pumpkin, you know, the one that just says pumpkin on the tin, not pumpkin pie filling. And then it should be 100% oil, but I've started doing 50% oil and 50% yogurt, which is a huge difference in fat calories and even makes it moister. Mm-hmm. A little bit of water. I beat that up till it had lovely air bubbles before we went on air. And then in here I have my gluten-free flour blend, which is not just potato starch and tapioca, it has millet and sorghum from some extra strength and rigidity, the bit of xanthan gum, baking powder and baking soda, and then I use Trader Joe's pumpkin pie spice, which is significantly cheaper than anything that's in the stores, and they only have it in the fall, so you can use it for your apple pie, your pumpkin pie, anything like that. It's about $2 for this, which is nothing.
Right. But now, when you talk about the xanthan gum and all those, you can find those at your regular
ordinary
grocery
stores. Bob's Red Mill, normally in most stores, has a huge display of all the gluten-free flours, which are clearly mentioned, marked gluten-free, and the xanthan gum, and it's horrendously expensive, so I try and keep putting less and less and less in, because too much makes stuff rubbery. So that's all beaten together. This I also put in almond meal to give you a better protein and better nutrition. Mm-hmm. And I would normally just whisk it with the whisk, but that's too noisy, or the electric beater, should I say. So imagine this has got the lumps out of it. Mm-hmm. It's going to thicken that little bit like it does for pancakes. We're going to put it, I've got craisins and pecans here. If you don't want the fruit, do half and half.
Some cupcakes.
I put it into the bundt pan here, made them as cupcakes for the kids with cream cheese frosting and some Halloween stuff on, like this for Thanksgiving. This recipe plus sweet potato casserole and my cornbread into a cornbread sausage stuffing with apples, that'll be in National Foundation for Celiac Awareness in November. And then December I'll have soft lady fingers made into English sherry trifle or tiramisu from the same cake batter from scratch. So very evil, very good. And they taste. You know, I've said before, if my son didn't like it, I'd hear all about it. So it's going to taste good.
All right.
Plus the crew eats it here as well.
Right.
So.
Oonagh, thank you so much.
You're
we'll
welcome.
Be right back.